Namaskar and welcome to this another episode of Raga Parichay. We move on with the Kalyan family and look at a very, very mystical rag, you know, rag Saraswati. Now Saraswati is also known as Saraswati Kalyan and it does belong to the Kalyan family and it is a beautiful fusion of the Kalyan Ang with the Jhinjhoti. It takes on the Komal Nishad of Jhinjhoti, the Daivat Komal Nishad of Jhinjhoti and tries to match up with the Tivra Madhyam and the Pare Sangati of the Kalyan Ang. Now this rag is mystical because it doesn't really offer much to expand upon, you know. Now when we go on to look at the chalan of the rag, we will notice that there is not much harmony built within the structure of the rag. And such rags which do not offer harmonic pairs, you know, to work with, tend to become very short in their presentations. And in case of Saraswati, some of the combinations are really very, not very soothing to the ear. And in fact, there have been instances in the old film era where Saraswati used to be used as a melody for creating suspense music. So let us go on to look at the chalan of Saraswati. And see how, you know, someone has attempted to mix the Kalyan Ang with the Jhinjhoti. This is quite a recent addition to the raga scenario. So this is quite a recent rag. So let us go on to look at Saraswati. So the Kalyan Ang. This rag omits the Gandhar altogether, and which is a major factor because it reduces the canvas, you know, the size of the canvas quite a lot in the Purvanga. It is just the Sare, Tivra Madhyam and the Pancha. Sare Mama Pa Pare. So the Pare of the Kalyan remains coming through the Tivra Madhyam. Amare. But then there is no Gandhar, you know, which is so very prominent in all the other Kalyans. So this omits the Gandhar altogether. Sare Sa. This Sare Sa becomes very, very prominent and essential here because then you move on to Sare Ma Ma Pa. Sare Ma Ma. Re ma ma pa. And unlike the Sham Kalyan or some of the Sarang, the Shuddha Sarang, there is no touch of Komal Madhyam or the Shuddha Madhyam here. So the Re, Sa Re Ma is quite a straight connection. Sa Re Ma Ma Pa Pa Re Ma Pa Re Sa Re Sa. This is the part of Jhinjhoti.
Mm-hmm.
re ni da sa. This is the Zinzoti phrase. Sa re ni da pa da sa. Absolute Zinzoti. Zinzoti would use the Shuddha Madhyam there, but this is Saraswati Kalyan, so it connects the Tivra Madhyam. And then to move on into the Uttaranga. And then you move on with the Zinzoti phrase. With the Komal Nishad. Structure of the rag, and as I said in the beginning, you know, you don't really find matching pairs of notes. Matching meaning pairs having Shaja Pancham or Madhyam Bhav between them. You know, the Rishab Tivra Madhyam doesn't really have anything. The Tivra Madhyam and Komal Nishad don't really match. Tivra Madhyam Daivat doesn't really match. So the Purvanga and Uttaranga does not really have a basis of symmetry, you know, to develop the rag. And so the development of the rag is limited in its scope of expanding. Now you do hear this rag, you know, performed by quite a few instrumentalists. Vocalists have used this also. But this would normally be the second rag of the performance because of its smaller span of development. There are a few beautiful natagits in Marathi based on this rag. Let us go on to listen to a very simple bandish in Saraswati.
Thank you.
So that was short and not so sweet, Saraswati. Now there are many other rags, you know, which have been created using the Kalyan part and another rag, fusion, you know, mixtures of rags. Like this was Jinjoti and Kalyan. There is Shiva Kalyan, which mixes the Shivaranjani and the Kalyananga, the Yaman. Then there is Hamsa Kalyan, mixing the Hamsadvani and the Yaman. So these are, you know, sort of mixtures of rags. You can see the two rags independent of each other. You can see parts of Shivaranjani and parts of Yaman in Shiva Kalyan. Maybe in some other episode we will take up Shiva Kalyan separately. A beautiful combination there. In our journey with the Kalyan family, we now move on to another set of rags, which are not mixtures, but you know, you could call them compounds. They distinctly show the Kalyan Anga, but you can't really make out the combinant rags, you know, the other rags which are a part of these. We will begin with Shyam Kalyan in the next session. I did a session on Shyam Kalyan many months ago, so I think I'll repeat that part a bit. So we will take up Shyam Kalyan in the next episode. Shyam Kalyan is a compound of, say, Shuddha Sarang and Kamod and Kalyan, and it shows Kamod Anga. In fact, Kamod has been carved out as a separate Ragang from the Kalyan Anga, and Shyam Kalyan does, you know, show the Kamod Anga in it. So we will move on with Shyam Kalyan next week, and then with this as a theme, then we follow with many more rags like the Nanda and the Hamir and Chayanat and Gautsarang and Kedar and many more. So Shyam Kalyan next week.